गुड मॉर्निंग माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू योर सोशल स्टडीज क्लास। एज वी आर स्टार्टिंग आवर एनुअल सिलेबस चैप्टर नंबर 11, लोकेशन ऑफ स्टेट्स ऑन द मैप ऑफ इंडिया। सो आई रिक्वेस्ट यू ऑल टू ओपन योर सोशल स्टडीज बुक Chapter 11, page number 87. So, let's start. As we can see in the book, today we are going to study in detail about the location of the states on the map of India. India is a beautiful country blessed with natural resources. India has one of the oldest civilization in the world and the seventh largest country in area of the world. Now, as we know, India is a very beautiful country and we have different types of natural resources. So, and also India has got one of the oldest civilization in the world. And according to the area, if we talk about the area, it is the seventh largest country. Now, it is the second most populous country after China. And when we talk about the population, after China, on the second rank, our country comes. It is the second most populous country. It covers an area of 32,87,263 square kilometer, extending from the snow-covered Himalayan heights to the tropical rainforest of the south. Now, the area which our India covers is 32,87,263 square kilometer. Now, as the seventh largest country in the world, India stands apart from the rest of Asia, marked by the mountains and the seas, which gives the country a distinct geographical entity. Now, in whole world, our India stands on the seventh number as the largest country, and apart from the rest of the Asia, marked by the mountains and the sea, which give a country a different geographical entity. Due to its beauty, due to its mountains, seas and all things, we have a distinct geographical entity. The geographical area comprises 2.4% of the total area of the world. Now, the area which is covered by the geographical, that is 2.5% of the total area of the world. Now, let's move on to the second page we have. As you can see, a map is given there. Different states are mentioned. So, this is our Indian map containing different states. So, as you can see, we start from the Jammu and Kashmir, and at the bottom we have our Kerala. So at the west we have Gujarat, and in the east we have many states. So please, I request you all to go through all these maps. So look at the above political map of India. India is divided into 28 states, 9 union territories. Now, before it was 29 states and 7 union territories, but now we have 28 states and 9 union territories, including the national capital territory of India. In the extreme north is the union territory of Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh. Kanyakumari lies in the southern tip of the mainland of India. New Delhi is India's capital. Now is the same thing which I have described you already. In the extreme north, we have the Jammu Kashmir and Ladakh, and southern tip of the mainland, we have Kanyakumari. And India, New Delhi is India's capital. Our capital of India is New Delhi. Now, from Kashmir to Kanyakumari, our country is about 3,965 kilometers long, and from Gujarat in the west to Arunachal Pradesh in the east is about 2,457 kilometers. So, the distance between them is given, like from Kashmir to Kanyakumari, it is 3,965, and from Gujarat to Arunachal Pradesh, it is 2,457 kilometers. And India is the widest in the middle. When we see the middle map, as you can see, it is widest. बट वेन इट्स इट बिकम्स नैरो टूवर्ड्स द साउथ एज यू सी दैट कन्याकुमारी पार्ट केरला पार्ट इट बिकम्स नैरो एंड गुजरात हैज़ द लार्जेस्ट कोस्ट लाइन 1600 किलोमीटर इन इंडिया. सो नाउ वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द names of the states, their capitals and the union territories of India and their capital. So everybody please listen very carefully and even you have to learn the state's capital, union territories and their capital. So let's start. The southern part of India is surrounded by three big water bodies. In the east it is Bay of Bengal, in the west it is Arabian Sea and towards south is the Indian Ocean. So India is only the country in the world which has been named after an ocean, like Indian Ocean. So in whole world, India is only the country which has a ocean after its name. Okay. Now here is the list of states and union territories of India and their capital. So please, I request you all to go through these capitals and states and even you have to learn. So once we will discuss Andhra Pradesh, Hyderabad, Arunachal Pradesh, Itanagar, Assam, Dishpur, Bihar, Patna, Chhattisgarh, Raipur, Goa, Panaji, Gujarat, Gandhinagar, Haryana, Chandigarh, Himachal Pradesh, Shimla, Jharkhand, Ranchi, Karnataka, Bangalore, Kerala, Trivandrum, मध्य प्रदेश भोपाल, महाराष्ट्र मुंबई, मणिपुर इम्फाल, मेघालय शिलोंग, मिजोरम ऐज़वाल, नागालैंड कोहिमा, उड़ीसा भुवनेश्वर, पंजाब चंडीगढ़, राजस्थान जयपुर, सिक्किम गैंगटॉक, तमिलनाडु चेन्नई, तेलंगाना हैदराबाद, त्रिपुरा अगरतला, उत्तराखंड देहरादून, उत्तर प्रदेश लखनऊ, West Bengal, Kolkata. So total we have 28 states and their capitals we have discussed. Now we are going to see about the union territories and their capital. So total union territories we have are 9 union territories. So once we will discuss Andaman and Nicobar Island, Port Blair, Chandigarh, Chandigarh, Dadra and Nagar Haveli, Silvassa, Daman and Diu, Daman, Delhi, Territory of India, Delhi, लक्षद्वीप आइलैंड कवरत्ती पुडुचेरी पुडुचेरी लद्दाख लेह जम्मू एंड कश्मीर श्रीनगर. सो नाउ वी हैव डिस्कस देयर कैपिटल्स आल्सो. नाउ नेक्स्ट टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द फिजिकल डिवीजन ऑफ इंडिया. एज दीज फिजिकल डिवीजन यू हैव स्टडीड बिफोर आल्सो दैट व्हाट आर फिजिकल डिवीजन्स. सो डिफरेंट लैंडफॉर्म्स एंड रिवर्स कम अंडर फिजिकल डिवीजन. द सर्फेस ऑफ द अर्थ इज नॉट यूनिफॉर्म एट ऑल प्लेसेस. So in India, the surface also varies from place to place. Like somewhere it is plain, somewhere it is desert, somewhere it is mountains. So we have very high mountains, vast plains, huge deserts and a great plateau regions. Many rivers originate from mountains and flow to plains. At many places, these rivers make waterfalls. As you can see in the picture, mountains are there, hills are there, valleys, desert, plains, plateau. So different landforms we are having. Our country is marked by the diversity of physical features such as mountains, plateau, desert, plains, coast and island. Like different diversity is marked in our country. Different physical features we have, like some mountains are there, plateaus, desert, plain, coast and island. These are the mountains in the north, Himalayan mountains, the northern plains, the great Indian desert in the west, the peninsular plateau in the south, the coastal plains, Thailand. So these are the different they have given us mentioned in the book. Once again I will read out. The mountains in the north that are as Himalayan mountain, the northern plains, Great Indian Desert in the west is there, Peninsula Plateaus in the south, the coastal plains and the island. As you can see the map also given here, with brown color mountains are marked, with the dark green color is your plain, desert with yellow color, plateaus with the light brown or orange we can see, coastal plains is with the light green. So now we'll discuss about the rivers of India. Based on the source, the Indian rivers are divided into Himalayan rivers and Peninsular rivers. Two types of rivers we have, Himalayan rivers and Peninsular rivers. These rivers are divided on the basis of the source of water, okay? The Himalayan rivers are rivers which originate from the Himalayan glaciers. Himalayan rivers, they originate from the Himalayan glaciers. They are the Indus river system, the Ganga river system, the Yamuna river system, and the Brahmaputra river system. Now we talk about the Peninsular river. They do not originate from the glaciers. These rivers are rain fed. Means these rivers get the water when there is a rain. Okay, they are not getting from water from any other source. They are rain fed rivers. They even reduce considerably during summer. So in the summer time, as there is no rainfall, so that's why even in these types of rivers which are rain fed, so that water is not there. Some of the Peninsular rivers are Mahanadi, Krishna, the Kaveri, the Narmada, the Tapi, etc. So all these rivers are Peninsular rivers, and Himalayan rivers are the rivers which originate from the Himalayan glaciers, and mostly they flow throughout the year. So these are the add to your knowledge. Please read, add to your knowledge, quickies, and let us revise. As in this quickies and let us revise, small summary of the chapter is given about the definition, about the words which you can't understand, like populous, having a large population, entity, a thing with distinct and independent existence, waterfall, a cascade of water falling from a height, physiographic, the branch of geography dealing with the natural featured extremity, the farthest point. So class, I request you to read the chapter once again so that you can understand the chapter, like about the states and capital, union territories and capital, major landforms of the India, and rivers of the India. All these things are important. So please go through the chapter once again. So thank you class. Have a nice day.